Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info.
Scientists studying the surface features of the dwarf planet Ceres are proposing a new theory for its geologic history. One problem facing NASA investigators is the absence of exceptionally large so-called impact basins from collisions, which planetary scientists believe must have occurred over the dwarf planet's supposedly ancient geologic age. Rather than considering that these giant impacts may have simply never happened, the investigators are proposing that mysterious processes have smoothed the surface of Ceres, erasing its largest craters over time. A phys.org report describes the failure of collision models to predict what scientists have actually found. It states, "The team's simulations of collisions with Ceres predicted that it should have 10 to 15 craters larger than 250 miles in diameter, and at least 40 craters larger than 60 miles wide. In reality, however, Dawn found that Ceres has only 16 craters larger than 60 miles, and none larger than the 177-mile Kirwan Basin. The solution the team is proposing is that theoretical ice in Ceres' crust has caused the topography of large impact craters to weaken and relax over time, smoothing the features to the point that they disappear. Dawn scientist David Williams also suggests that internal heat from the decay of radioactive elements may have also played a role in erasing the hypothetical giant impact basins. But is this another example of space scientists today simply performing patchwork on existing theory, rather than exploring new pathways of discovery? Scientists have also proposed resurfacing of the planet Venus due to its lack of expected so-called impact craters. Paradoxically, some bodies in the solar system, including the Saturnian moon Tethys, the Martian moon Phobos, and the asteroid Vesta, show craters so enormous that they probably should have shattered the bodies if they were caused by impacts. Indeed, like virtually every other rocky body imaged to date, Ceres poses major challenges to standard geology and to the consensus history of our solar system. The surface of Ceres is carpeted with varieties of weird craters, including an abundance of hexagonal craters, such as those also seen on Mars, Mercury, and the Saturnian moons Mimas and Dione. We also see an abundance of bullseye craters, which are craters with central interior craters, as well as craters with central peaks, and chains of craters. Nor is the extreme circularity of craters on Ceres a new mystery for planetary scientists. In the 20th century, investigations into our own moon caused many adjustments to the theory of impact cratering, since the more than 90% of circular craters on the moon demand that the objects strike vertically. A similar puzzle is seen on Ceres. As one commenter noted to the Thunderbolts Project, far too many of the Ceres craters are, quote, 90 degrees axial to the center of the body, as if every single so-called object impact was vectored exactly towards the nucleus, leaving no side-swiping impacts. Let's see the math that speaks to such a probability. This image displays the evidence of a globalized dynamic process. It's also unlikely that the dwarf planet has sufficient gravity to influence the paths of incoming objects at speeds sufficient to cause such circular cratering. But as described in previous episodes, electric arcs always strike the surface from directly above. In the electric universe theory, most if not all of the massive cratering seen on Ceres occurred when the dwarf planet was electrically excavated from a larger planetary body. Consider the side-by-side comparison of the surface of Ceres on the right and an image of anode cratering in an electrical discharge machining process on the left. Like the supposedly disappearing giant impact basins on Ceres, Dawn scientists imagine that special conditions under the visible surface of Ceres are the cause of the dwarf planet's numerous hexagonal craters. They have theorized that colliding bodies have perfectly struck underground faults and cracks to form the unique cratering pattern, a process that has also been proposed for hexagonal features on other planets and moons. In a Thunderbolts article, Picture of the Day managing editor Steve Smith questions this logic. He writes, "How can the detonation of a colliding rock cause a hexagonal crater? No experiment has been able to demonstrate a polygonal shape left behind after an explosive event. Explosions do not aggregate into stable configurations. They induce chaotic behavior that leaves little in the way of identifiable forms. To propose that it is pre-existing stress patterns is to say that straight-edged underground faults and cracks are everywhere, and in just the right arrangements for square, pentagonal, or hexagonal formations to result from explosive impacts. But the ideal analogs for planetary craters may be found in electrical discharge experiments. Electrically scarred worlds like Ceres defy the standard story of our solar system's formation and history, and can offer new paths of discovery toward a better understanding of our electric universe.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.